Because I'm happy. I'm a Muslim, that's what makes me happy, and that's the truth.
Yes, brother.
My name is Aryaputra Kumar Narayan Singh Konte from Delhi. I speak no continue English to English. I'm very, very sorry. सर मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ क्या भगवान के बनाए हुए सभी नियमों में परिवर्तन होता रहता है क्या? मैं इसलिए पूछना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि इस्लाम धर्मावली बोलते हैं कि यानी कि मनुष्य का कभी पूर्ण जन्म नहीं होता है, और जबकि श्रीमद् भागवत गीता में श्री कृष्णा ने अर्जुन से कहा है हे पार्थ कि इंसान यानी कि कई बार जन्म लेता है, शायद तुम्हें नहीं मालूम है मेरे कई जन्म हो चुके हैं। मैंने पहला जो गीता का ज्ञान दिया था वो पहले मनु को दिया था, जिसे आप शायद नू इस्लाम का नाम से जानते होंगे, और दूसरी बार कहते हैं कि मैंने सूर्य देव को यह ज्ञान दिया था, उसके बाद मैं आपको दे रहा हूँ। तो सर आप क्या बता सकते हैं कि मनुष्य का पूर्ण जन्म होता है या नहीं होता है? क्या भगवान के बनाए हुए नियमों में क्या परिवर्तन होता रहता है क्या समय अनुसार? मैं ये पूछना चाहता हूँ।
The brothers asked two questions. The first question is, can there be change in the law and the teachings of Almighty God? Can there be changes? And question two is, that can a person be reborn? Can he be reborn? And he quoted a verse of the Gita, which I'll come to it later on. As far as the first question is concerned, can the laws of God keep on changing? If the law of God is time-bound, if it's meant for only a particular group of people and for a particular time period, it will keep on changing. For example, as I mentioned in my talk, Torah, Zabur, Injil, all of them were revelation of God, but they were meant for a particular group of people and for a particular time period. But once the last and final revelation of God has been revealed, nothing new can be added, nothing can be subtracted. Quran is the last and final revelation of Almighty God. No other revelation is going to come. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last and final messenger. There is no other messenger to come. Allah says in Surah Azab, chapter 30, verse number 40, مَا قَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَهْدٍ مِّنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاقِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَقْحَاتَمُ النَّبِينَ وَقَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْنَ عَلِيمًا. That Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the father of any of you men, but he is the messenger of Allah and is the seal of the prophets. And Allah is all-knowing, full of wisdom. After Prophet Muhammad, if anyone says that he is a messenger of God, he gets revelation, then he requires a psychiatrist. Prophet Muhammad is the last and final messenger. After Quran, no other revelation is going to come. And Quran clearly mentioned in Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 3, on this day, have I completed my religion for you, and I've chosen for you Islam, and complete my favor on you. Once the religion is completed, nothing new can be added, nothing can be subtracted. So as far as your question, yes, the old revelations, there can be changes. But the basic message from the first revelation till the last about Tawheed, about oneness of God, is the same. So all the revelations that came before the Quran, they have not maintained their pure form. They have been changed by human beings. And because it was not meant for eternity, Almighty God didn't feel it fit to be preserved. But as far as the Quran is concerned, Allah says in Surah Hijr, chapter number 15, verse number 9, we have revealed the Quran and we shall guard it from corruption. This Quran, even if all the human beings try and change the Quran, they cannot do it. All the human being and jinn, they get together, they can't change the Quran. So as far as the previous revelation, yes, there can be a change. But the final revelation, no, it cannot be changed. It is the ultimate. Now coming to your second question.
No, second question here, sir.
The second question mein jura raha bhi.
Yani Allah ke paas teen nek bande jo rehte hain, unmein hamari aur se Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, tino ke kaam alag alag hain. यानी कि पहला ब्रह्मा, यानी कि जैसा जो जीव काम करता है उसके हिसाब से उसको जन्म यानी कि योनि में भेज देते हैं। दूसरा काम है विष्णु, जो विष्णु जी हैं वो जीवों की पालना पोषणा की ओर ध्यान देते हैं। तीसरे जो महादेव हैं, जिनको देवादिदेव महादेव यानी कि शिव शंकर बोलते हैं, यानी कि वो सब का हिसाब बराबर करते हैं। यानी कि आपके पास जो यानी कि अल्लाह ताला के पास जो तीन बंदे नेक बंदे रहते हैं उनका भी काम क्या यही है?
भाई साहब आपने इस्राइल नया सवाल पूछा
जी,
इसका जवाब दूंगा। पहले पुराने सवाल का जवाब दूं क्या? नहीं मैं
जी।
आपने पुनर्जन्म की बात की बराबर
जी,
तो उसका जवाब चाहिए या नहीं चाहिए?
चाहिए
चाहिए ना। तो पहला पुनर्जन्म की बात करूंगा, फिर आपकी ब्रह्मा विष्णु और शिवा की भी बात करूंगा, हाँ इंशाल्लाह तीनों की बात करूंगा मैं. The brother asked another new question. So I told him, first I'll reply to the old question, then I'll come to a new question. His previous question was that, do you believe in reincarnation, in a second life? As far as reincarnation is concerned, what you quoted is Bhagavad Gita. But the highest scripture in Hinduism is Ved. Vedas are number one. They are the Shrutis. Then later on come the Smritis. Mahabharata, part of Mahabharata is Bhagavad Gita. Though Bhagavad Gita is more widely read than the Vedas, but authenticity in grade, Veda is higher. The Ved speaks about Punarjanam. Punarjanam means next life. And if you read the Quran too speaks about next life. Quran says you'll come in this world, you'll die, again you'll be resurrected. Punar means next, Janam means life. Punarjanam. Nowhere does the Veda speak about death, life, death, life, death, life, death, life. Nowhere. Nowhere. Neither does the Bhagavad Gita speak about that. What you quoted to me is a verse of Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 4, verse number 22. I'm giving you the reference. Where it's mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, according to the Hindus, it's the word of Almighty God. And it says that as the human beings keep on changing the clothes, they throw away the old clothes and put on new clothes, same way the soul will take a new body. Will throw away the old body, new body. I have got no problem. In this world, you have this body. When you die, you are resurrected, new body, no problem. It is matching with the Quran, matching with the Veda. But this philosophy, what you're talking about reincarnation, in Sanskrit, it is called as samskara. The theory of reincarnation, the theory of life and death, called as rebirth, correct? Now this theory was propounded by the scholars of Hinduism. It's nowhere mentioned in the Vedas. Why? Because they could not justify. Some people are born deaf, some people born rich, some people born in a poor family, some people are born healthy, some people congenital heart disease. How can God be unjust? So they couldn't justify, so they came with the philosophy of death, life, karma and dharma. Karma is the deed, action, dharma is the law. So what justification? How can God be unjust? How can a person be born with a heart disease? Last life, he did some sin. This was a philosophy assumption by the scholars of Hinduism, not by Ved. So then they came with this philosophy and they say that if you do good deeds, in your next life, you will be born of a higher degree. And the universal brotherhood of Hinduism is all living creatures are brotherhoods. So maybe you're born sometime as a cockroach, sometime as a rat, sometime as a cat, sometime as a dog, sometime as human being. Human being is the highest level. So if you do good deeds, you're born higher. If you do bad deeds, you're born lower. Fine? And you're born as a human being 7 times. How many times? 7. This is the philosophy of the Hindu scholars, called as samsara. Now I'm asking you a question, brother. In this world, sin is increasing or decreasing? Sin, paap par rahe ke ghat rahe? Bad rahe, mashallah, very good. Sin is increasing. Population of human being, insan jo janta, insan hai bad rahe ke ghat rahe? Population bad rahe ke ghat rahe? Bad rahe, mashallah. So sin is also increasing and human beings are increasing. If sin is increasing, human beings should decrease. So what we realize, logically, it's not correct. Therefore, I believe in Punarjanam. Punarjanam is next life, which even Quran speaks about next life. But only one. You come in this world only once. Now coming to your third question about Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh or Shiva. Same. Two names, Mahesh and Shiva, same. But more popular one is Shiva. Right? The creator, the destroyer, the sustainer. Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. And you ask me that does God have these three forms? No, God doesn't have three forms. Does he have any people? Yes, he has many angels. See, alone God is sufficient. He does not require anyone's help. But if he wants, he can do it through an angel, if he wants. If he doesn't want, no problem. He just wills and it is. Kun fayakun. Be and it is. As far as the Hindus, what they believe, they believe in somewhat similar trinity what the Christians believe, even the Hindus believe. that Almighty God, one God is God to create, Brahma. One God is God to destroy, Shiva. One God is God to sustain, Vishnu. So separate God for creation, separate God for sustaining, separate God for destroying. The Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse number 22, if there were gods more than one God, surely they would have fought among themselves. And Quran says in Surah Mu'minun, chapter number 23, verse number 91, that if there were many gods, they would have piled upon one another. And that's what you find in the Hindu mythology. One God fighting with the other God, one God defeating the other God, third God helping the second God. How can gods fight? So best is only one God. Superpower is only one. And that is what the Ved says. If you ask a common Hindu, how many gods does he believe in? Some will say 3, some will say 100, some will say 1,000, some will say 33 crores, 330 million. But if you ask a learned Hindu that how many gods should a Hindu believe in, he will tell you Hindus should believe only in one God. But the common Hindu, he believes in a philosophy known as pantheism. What he says? That everything is God. The tree is God, the sun is God, the moon is God, the human being is God, and the snake is God. What we Muslims say, everything is God's. G-O-D with an apostrophe S. Everything belongs to God. The tree belongs to God, the sun belongs to God, the moon belongs to God, the human being belongs to God, as well as the snake belongs to God. So the major difference between the Hindus and the Muslims is the Hindus say everything is God. We Muslims say everything is God's. G-O-D with an apostrophe S. The major difference is apostrophe S. If we can solve this difference of apostrophe S, the Hindus and the Muslims will be united. How do we do it? Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ قَلْمِتِنْ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا بَيْنَكُمْ. Come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. That we worship none but Allah. وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا. That we associate no partners with Him. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. That we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا. If then they turn back. فَقُولُوا اشْهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ. Say we bear witness that we are Muslims bowing our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best way to analyze any religion is not to try and understand what the followers are doing, but you have to analyze the scriptures. Now, if we analyze the Hindu scriptures, if we read the Upanishads, which Ved Upanishad the highest, it's mentioned in Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1, Ekam Evidityam. God is only one without a second. It is a Sanskrit quotation. Ekam Evidityam. God is only one without a second. It's mentioned in Shweta Sitara Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9, Nachaste Kasij, Janitana Chadipa. Of him, there is no Lord. He has got no parents. Almighty God has got no superior. He has got no mother. He has got no father. It's mentioned in the Sweta Svetara Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, Natasya Pratima Asti. Of that God, there is no Pratima. Pratima means image. Pratima means photograph, idol, sculpture, painting. Almighty God has got no photograph, has got no sculpture, has got no statue, has got no painting. He has got no images. And amongst the Hindu scriptures, the most sacred are the Ved. It's mentioned in Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3. Natasya Pratimasti. Of that Almighty God, there is no Pratima, there is no images, there is no photograph, there is no sculpture, there is no statue. It's mentioned in Yajurved, chapter number 40, verse number 8. Almighty God is pure. It's mentioned in Yajurved chapter 40, verse number 9, Andhatma Pavishanti Ya Asambhuti Mupaste. They are entering darkness, those who worship the Asambhuti. Asambhuti are the natural things like fire, water, air, etc. And the verse continues, they are entering more in darkness, those who worship the Sambhuti. Sambhuti are the created things like table, chair, idol, etc. Who says that? Yajurved chapter 40, verse number 9. And the Brahma Sutra of Hinduism is Ekam Braham. देवता नास्ते ने ना नास्ते किंचन भगवान एक ही है दूसरा नहीं है नहीं है नहीं है जरा भी नहीं है देयर इज ओनली वन गॉड नॉट अ सेकंड वन नॉट एट ऑल नॉट इन द लीस्ट बिट
वी लाइक आवर ऑडियंस टू गिव दिस यंग बॉय अ गुड हैंड बिकॉज आई थिंक व्हेन वी आर यंग वी आर मोर इनोसेंट वी आर मोर राइटियस वी आर मोर ट्रूथफुल ही इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ इट पुटिंग अ वेरी जेन्युइन क्वेश्चन ही हैड अ जेन्युइन क्वेश्चन ही बिलीव्ड इन अ जेन्युइन अप्रोच Alhamdulillah.
We would tell beautiful things by this man.
Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him. He taught us to love and to care for each other. That is the sunnah of the chosen one.